What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 10 of the Ultimate Let's Play Fire Emblem. We completed the first side quest of the game in the previous episode, and now we continue our march to Caelin here in Chapter 8. It's called Vortex of Strategy. Passing through Arafin and Cathalat, Lynn and her friends arrive in Caelin. However, Caelin is now under the rule of Lord Lundgren. Lundgren's henchmen lay in wait to assassinate Lynn. They wait for her approach and ready a special weapon. And that looks like a damn ballista. Oh boy. Chapter 8, Vortex of Strategy. Look, Mark, the mountain seems so far away now. We've come such a long way. My Lady Lindis, Mark, we can't be very far from the castle now. By my reckoning, we can reach Castle Caelin in 2 days if we hurry. 2 more days. Hold on, Grandfather, please. Cheer up, Lynn. If they see you looking sad, the entire company will lose heart. Florina, you're right. There's nothing to be gained by worrying. We just have to press onward. That's the spirit. Lynn, danger approaches. What'd you say? I don't see anything. Are you sure? I feel it too. I'm sure of it. Ah! Malie, don't move! What in... Where'd this bolt come from? They have a ballista. Lord Lundgren is getting serious. Deploying siege engines is no mean feat. What's a ballista? It's a weapon designed for long-distance attacks. Only archers can use them, but they can be devastating. Florina, you must stay aground. Do not take to the air. The ballista would target you in an instant. Is there a way to combat it? The safest course is to use some good defense as bait so the enemy wastes arrows. Then you can walk up and knock the fool on the head. Will, can you use a ballista? I've never tried, but it's just a really big bow, right? I should be able to figure it out. All we can ask is that you try. Let's see what we can do. Ah, Lady Lindis, Mark, I have some minor business to attend to. I'm unable to join you. If you need any of my possessions, please take them now. So we're not going to be using Florina, and apparently not using Matthew in this battle either. So, I'm going to take Florina out of the lineup. I can't use Matthew. I'll have to use either Sand or Nils. I don't really plan on using Nils at all, so we'll just keep Sand in the lineup here. But Florina is grounded for this mission for her own protection. Do you have anything we need? Oh. Yes, you do. That hammer that Matthew got in the previous chapter. That is a axe weapon for taking down armored enemies. We don't need the store key anymore. But if I come across an armored enemy like a knight or a general, this weapon would be very beneficial. And I guess we're okay for now in terms of weaponry here. Alright, now let's have a look at the map here. Formation. I see we got some magic users coming up over here. I'll have Kent ride up behind Lucius. Okay, I think this is how we're gonna do it. We have an armory right here if we need to buy new weaponry. So I think I'll have maybe Wrath stop by. Wrath only he's got plenty of space in his inventory there. Alright, so I think we've done all we can do, so let's get it on. Oh, don't wanna save. I just wanna go fight. On the far side of the hill to the south is a ballista. As Kent said, it's weapon intended for trained archers. The attack range of ballista is extremely large. They can fire on enemies at great distances. As they can attack without fear of counterattack, they're quite useful. To use one, you move an archer on an unoccupied ballista and select the ride command. After that, you can attack as usual. Ballista can also be moved while in use. Additionally, ballista can only be used by any archer in the field. So if you can move the enemy manning the ballista and move one of your group onto it, you'll find it most useful. Indeed. Okay, so 14 enemies to defeat here. We'll have Lucius lie in wait there in the woods. Because he's going to be bringing these two guys out. We'll have, Kent and Irk flank them. And we're going to start making our way around here. Nowhere near striking range here. And we'll have Wrath stop by the armory. Anything we can get here? Well, we can get another bow for Will, and even for Wrath. I'll buy one for Wrath, and I guess I'll buy another axe just in case we need it. That's fine. All we need is the bow. Sarah, you go with them, and we'll have Sane come with us. Okay, let's see what they're gonna do here. I'm aiming for Sarah. Ooh, that hurt. Yeah, unfortunately, Sarah can't heal herself unless she's got a vulnerary on her person. And Lucius is getting the kill there. Very nice. Alright, he's coming at us with Flux. Now we've got the weapon advantage here. You missed. And Lucius is proving himself to be a very useful addition to our team. Very early here. Does Sarah have any, she's got plenty of vulneraries, okay. So we're just gonna have her move closer to this. Actually, you know what, we'll, have you go there since the coast is clear. Heal yourself up. Alright. And bummer, I can't quite reach, this archer. Maybe I'll have you come down a bit. Okay, you take this guy out, hopefully get a crit. You know, maybe I should have gotten another bow. I'll go ahead and trade Will here. What the heck, I'll use this pure water on myself here. I don't think it's gonna really do much, but there you go. Alright, Lynn, go ahead and take this guy out. Okay. And you've got what? You've got a lance, so this is going to be beneficial for me. Doris has got a lot of HP. He can take quite a punch here. What are you curs waiting for? They're nothing but fleas. Call for reinforcements and rush them. Okay, they're going after Dorcas here. As I kind of expected. I don't think he's going to kill any of them. Actually, I stand corrected. He took that guy out. Now he's coming in. He got the hit in with the lance there, but he's gonna get chopped into bits. And let's go after Will, smart move. Because he can't counterattack. And going after Raph can't counterattack either. And went to attack Will there with the Ballista. No luck there. Okay. We took a little bit of damage, but nothing Sarah can't fix up. Although she has fallen a little behind us. Although you can heal up Will. Okay, and while we're here, we'll go ahead and have Kent visit the village. Do you remember the weapon triangle? Axes over lances and whatnot? This is important, so pay attention. There are some weapons that don't follow the normal rules. This here Lance Reaver is one of those. It's a sword that reverses the triangle. So if you wield this blade, you can best a lance with it. Of course, there's a downside. Axes can best this sword. Take it as a gift. It's your reward for listening to an old man ramble. Don't be so shy. It's not like I can use the thing. Not everyone can wield a sword of this caliber. I'm sure you know someone who could use it, though. So we just got a Lance Reaver sword. And I'm going to go ahead and shuck this old iron sword, since it's pretty much dead in the water. But yeah, that Lance Reaver reverses the weapon triangle. So basically, I'll be able to beat lances with it instead of being at a disadvantage. And I can't get on the mountain here and reach that. I can attack from a distance here. I would get the kill. I may take some damage. We gotta get that ballista. Alright. Let's have, can't quite kill any of these guys. So let's have Wrath set one up for you. Well, you'll kill that guy outright. I want Will to get the kill. Raph can at least set him up for me. Beautiful work. And we'll have Lin take this one out. We might need the Manikati for this one. Critical hit! Enemy's calling in some reinforcements now. More soldiers coming from those fortresses there. Yeah, I had a hunch that Ballista was going after Urk there, and now Urk's in critical condition. Alright. Okay, you're gonna have to fall back here. And you heal up, Urk. I don't know if it's going to be a full heal, but he needs it. Close enough. And I think I'm in range to take out this ballista here. Wrath will get the kill on this guy right here. Just plow the road. You've all got spears, right? Yeah, they've got lances, so... You get your, lances ready here, Sane. And... Dorcas, you go ahead and block the bridge as well. You've got that hammer, we might need that. I forgot about the guy in the ballista. Silly me. all about advancing here and, forgetting the obvious, getting rid of that ballista. And Dorcas scores a critical hit on that guy. And it's gonna be Lance against Lance when Sane goes up here. And he'll get the double. Bring it on. Oh, he's got an Axe Reaver. That hurt. Nevertheless, we still got that kill, though, but boy, did Dorcas take a hit there. Alright. Dorcas, I think you've done your fair share. Oh, man, he's down to his last HP there. Holy cow. I nearly made a critical error there. Alright, we're gonna take this guy out on the ballista. I wonder, can Rapt use this? No, he can't. But he can take this guy out. That's about to kill Dorcas. You know what? Rescue Sarah. Bring her a bit further down here. Alright. Dorcas, you gotta fall back here. We don't have to worry about the ballista anymore, but really heal up that wound. That was too close. Sane can take this guy out. I don't think I've had any level ups yet, to be honest with you. And a critical hit for Sane. Will, go ahead and ride. This thing's only got one round in it. I'll go after the big boss, Yogi, here. Curses, the ballista must have been taken. What's going on here? Somebody get that girl. And the ballista broke. It's out of ammo. So, we'll have to do without it then. Getting Dorcas back in the swing of things here. And go ahead and use another vulnerary to get yourself back to full health. Well, you have. You just have the Axe Reaver, so a counter against, axe users. Alright, we'll just go after you with the bow then. Now, this is one of those armored enemies I was telling you about. So that hammer would do greatly against our foe here. We'll javelin this guy, take him out of commission. So much for your little sword reaver. He's just gonna stay put and heal up. Sane's gonna heal up. Alright. Can you get the kill with the hammer? Well, problem. He's only got 37% accuracy, so I don't think that's gonna be the best way to do it. I guess the only way to do this for sure is to let Lin take this one. And one strike of the Monikati, and that's all. Lord Lundgren, I failed you. I pray you hurry with those reinforcements you promised. And Lin levels up, our first and only level up in this chapter. Finally, we get a little bit of strength. And our sword level increased. But that's all she wrote for this chapter. Is it over? Yes, I see no more enemy soldiers. However, something is bothering me. What is it? I noticed it during the fighting. Our opponents, they were soldiers of Caelin. I even recognized some of those we fought. I trained with many of them. And yet they attacked us without hesitation. They're black-hearted traitors who joined Lord Lundgren. Good riddance, I say. It also means less resistance at the castle. I hope you're right. I'm just glad Nils and Nien were with us. If that first shot hit me, I might not have survived. We are honored to have served you well. We won't let you down. I know, I'm relying on you. What's this? You dealt with the ballista too? Nicely done. Matthew, where were you during all this? I went to the village to sniff about for information. I got some interesting news from my trouble too. Let's hear it. First, about Marquess Caelin's illness. He really is unwell. He's been in bed for nigh on 3 months. Oh no, Grandfather. I heard an interesting rumor about his condition, though. The people believe that someone's been poisoning the Marquess. He's being poisoned? And this someone? Well, everyone's too afraid to mention a name. However, they say that as soon as the Marquess took ill, a certain noble took control of the castle as though it were his own. I fed a hungry innkeeper some coin, and he fed me a name. The Marquess of Caelin's own brother, Lord Lundgren. How could this be? How can they allow him to get away with this? The villagers know he's the one poisoning my grandfather, and yet no one raises a hand against him. Why? They're afraid, and they lack proof. The whisperings of the common people means nothing. That's the truth of it. And of the Marquess's loyal retainers who might have lent credence to these rumors, there is no sign. Are you saying they've been silenced? It's a fair assumption. This is beyond believing. The worst news is yet to come. What? There's more? An imposter has appeared, claiming to be the Marquess's granddaughter. At least that's the story Lundgren's telling to all who will listen. What does that mean? It means that people are waiting for two traitorous knights and a baseborn child to appear and lay claim to Castle Caelin. But that, it can't be. Traitors? Us? Ridiculous. He says, I'm an imposter? Do you have anything that proves your lineage? When my mother joined the Lorca, she brought nothing of Lycia with her. Milady Marquess Abraffin himself remarked your resemblance to Lady Madeline. Your face is your proof. They'll say we found a lookalike somewhere. We're seen as betrayers of our knightly vows. Our word means nothing. Now our only hope is to see Marquess Caelin himself. We must hurry. If not, my grandfather... I must see him with my last breath if need be. But we must formulate some manner of plan. Even if we stand out for the castle, the troops patrolling the area will cause no end of problems. You've been branded as Oathbreakers, after all. I've got it. Elliewood. He seems sympathetic to our plight. He should still be in Cathalette. If we can talk to him, he might help us. Of course, a sound idea. Let's hurry. Yes, back to Cathalette. So it looks like we're heading back to Cathalette to try and find Elliewood, because he may help us out in the coming battles. So now we know that Lord Lundgren is basically pulling out all the stops to maintain the stranglehold on Castle Caelin, poisoning the Marquess and branding his knights and his own, I guess, grandniece, I guess, as a traitor. So we're going to have to, this is going to require a little finesse on our part, but we'll save that adventure for the next episode, but we're going to call it quits here. I'll see you next time for Chapter 9. Until then, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.